Buenas tardes, good evening, everybody. Okay, my name is Dinaris Jauregui. I am not Puerto Rican. Yes, I am Peruvian.
We love you.
I love you. You're probably wondering why I probably don't want to participate in this. I guess ever since I met Lydia about, like, what, 15 years ago about?
Right here.
I was looking for something that involved Latino. I miss my Latino culture, And so we just kept getting involved, And I guess my, more likely centralized Puerto Rican love came about. Not only my love for people, my love for nature, my love for culture, but a person very dear to me, my partner, he was Puerto Rican. So, and that still stayed with me, and it's still, my love for the community is still there, and I participate a lot in my community, in any place I go. I think everywhere I've been, I still stay in contact with media, I still stay in contact with my different communities in California and Florida, and still try to help as much as possible. So currently, as far as my professional experience or current volunteer experience, I volunteer with Sarna's House, which is also along with Hope for Kids International, and we do medical clinics across the border in Sonoita. Participated in California with the San Diego River. I was part of the military, so I participated with a different volunteer works across the world. In Florida as well, with mainly with youth. As part of my educational background, I'm finishing up my program with business administration, concentration with global business management, and I think I can be an asset to the board. Whether elected or not, I'm still going to participate. And that's mainly anything that it's needed. I like project management. I like getting a project going. I like researching. I enjoy making the project from beginning to end run through. So a lot of focus, from what I've heard from our different meetings, is the youth. And that is greatly needed now. Everywhere I go, the youth is a huge focus. Mainly because we need some kind of strong roots, whether if it's Puerto Rican, whether if it's any culture really. I believe, as here in the Puerto Rican community, I believe that Puerto Rico serves like a hub for the Latino communities. So even though Puerto Rico may be seen as, you know, a Latino, or you know, sometimes they just consider it a territory. It's not. It's part of the U.S. It is a hub for all the other Latino cultures. It is a hub for all of us just to come together. So it's a mixture, like Hawaii. Hawaii is another hub, you know, but they're in a state. Anyhow, going back. the youth is, to me, it's very important. So I believe the concentration, at least getting, my goal for this is to at least get as, even if it's 10 within a year into college, then, you know, hopefully those number grows and hopefully those come back and do more community service within the Puerto Rican community or within just our community here as a whole. But I would like for Arizona itself to grow in sending as much as possible our Latino community into college in preparation, in whether if it's starting with the military, starting with college itself, but with preparation. A lot of people may not, may come from broken homes, may not come from broken homes, but regardless, is the person is trained from the beginning. They have the proper knowledge. We can say it takes a village to, you know, to care. So you have to, and for, I guess that's why I'm here. I'm not here as, I'm not Puerto Rican, but I'm here as a community member. I'm here to start here, and even when I'm gone or even when this is over, I would still like to participate. If you have any questions, you can ask me any questions.
What's the thought about you as more like helping, you know, start a project or teaching or what necessarily are you?
There's one particular thing that stands out. One time I was volunteering for my son's school, and when I asked this child, he was probably 10, and when I asked the child, what do you want to be? He told me, I want to be a hermit. I want to be nothing. I want to be a monk. That disturbed me, because for a youth to being in that kind of school, to having that teacher wanting to teach them, it wasn't enough. So it takes our community. It doesn't take only the parents. It takes an external party, because sometimes, even with my own son, I love my son dearly, but sometimes my son doesn't listen to me, you know, and that's understandable. But you have a trait that you can teach that child. She has a trait. The other person has one. All those skills combined will help that child be better prepared for that college, whether if it's Puerto Rican or not. There's Puerto Ricans that are Mexicans. There's Puerto Ricans that are Dominicans. There's Puerto Ricans that are Peruanos. I know when I go to Japan, there's Peruanos in Japan. I'm there standing in line, I didn't even know that person behind me was Peruano, and all of a sudden it was time. The same thing happens to me with Puerto Ricans wherever I go in different locations. But my focus right now, it is the youth. Because even my son, I have a lot of things to learn with my son. My son has a lot of things to learn from me. I have a lot of things to learn from my son. But I think as a community, yes, if we focus each and every one of our strengths and think of every single one of those kids, children, as important, but as an individual, we can make them stronger for college. We can make them a stronger asset in our community, because we are going to be dependent on them to be a strength for us when we come of age, if we can all take care of ourselves.
Mm-hmm.